Good morning, all the faculty members. Today, I, Shaurya Sharma, with my project partner, Devashish Sharma, would like to present in front of you our fourth year project, that is Facial Expression and Emotion Classification, under the guidance of Aishwarya Gupta ma'am. Now, with us, we have the table of contents, which include vision and mission, introduction of our project, literature survey of our project, problem statement, proposed solution, technology used, methodology, working, research paper and publication details, and references. On the very first, we have the vision and mission of our institute and our department, that is computer science and engineering. Now, let us start with the introduction of our project. So, the objective of our project is to build a model that is more reliable and fast to classify mood of the user, and also to gather information about the mood of individuals. As we all know, that expression of an individual contain more information regarding the mood and the state of mind of a particular person. Here comes the literature survey part. As we know, emotion plays a big role when it comes to know the mood of an individual. When we first see someone or picture of somebody, we don't know anything about that person, but we can capture emotion of that person just by looking at his face or by looking at the image of a person. Our emotions are frequently reflected on our face, in our gestures, and in our voice as well. In order to express our feelings, liking and disliking, we use our emotions. Research shows that the most expressive part of a human body is the human face. Most of the emotions are expressed by our facial expressions. Study shows that the vocal part express only 38% of our emotions, while the facial expression expresses 55% of our emotion, that is highest among all. And the vocal part of a message contributes only 7% that affect the message as whole, the vocal part for 38% while facial expression for 55% to the effect of a speaker's message. This made the fact clear that how important our facial expressions are in order to classify emotions of an individual. Our emotions are equally important when it comes to the social interactions where we interact with other people. Detecting people's needs, predicting people's reaction on something specific. And actually, emotion is very important in our life and have a strong influence in our cognition process. Emotions are now extensively studied in the area of psychology, computer science, neuroscience, and cognitive sciences as they play a significant role in human nature. In the classification of the emotions, there are two basic emotions are there, love and fear. Based on this, we classify the emotion into positive and negative emotions. The six basic emotions are angry, happy, fear, disgust, sad, surprise. One more expression is neutral. Other emotions are embarrassment, interest, pain, shame, shy, anticipation, smile, laugh, sorrow, hunger, curiosity, etc. The different type of expressions, namely joy, sadness, surprise, anger, disgust, and fear, etc. Important evidence about a person's emotion can be obtained from facial expressions. The facial action coding system, that is FACS, describes all the facial muscle movements that can be perceived in terms of predefined action units, which are encoded numerically. And the facial expression corresponds to the one or more of these action units. Recognizing emotion from facial expression has several advantages, such as it considers a natural way to identify emotion states. Many databases are available for facial expressions. Many tools support facial recognition are available to researchers. With this, next we move on to the problem statement. Facial recognizers are used to recognize the user expressions and mood and identify the mood of the users. Sometimes user faces issues of getting wrong results by their recognizers, as their predictions are wrong. If we change the angle of the face, or maybe the background of the image seems to be a major issue for them. Thus, it called a need to more ideal solution with increased accuracy and results. Hence, we propose our system to do so. With this, I would like to end my part and hand over the presentation to my project partner, Devashish Sharma. Thank you for giving your valuable time to us.
Thank you, Shaurya, for your explanation. Now, coming to my part for the proposed framework. In this proposed framework, we use the approach of CNN, in which we divide the single image into different convolutions of various size, and then up to 10 layers, we train the data according to the max pooling layer. As discussed earlier, model flow, since our first presentation, we use a facial recognition technique using the OpenCV, and we refine our results using the Keras and TensorFlow backend, and save the results in the H5 model in the binary format. The technologies used are the Jupyter Notebook and the Google Colab, which provides us the GPU for running the TensorFlow backend, and the programming language is Python 3. Now moving on to the working of the program. While moving to the working, first of all, we will install the TensorFlow and the required version of the TensorFlow for a model. Then we authenticate our Google Drive through which our Colab is working. And we're using the FAR 2013 GZ model for that. Now we restart our runtime so that it may work properly according to our need. Okay, now the runtime has been restarted, I think so. Now we'll authorize our Google Drive. After authorizing our Google Drive, I run my model and the theorem and the method we used for that. That's the Nade-Lucas theorem. In this algorithm, I use the 10 layers convolution, in which two different layers are for the eyes and one for the nose, which forms the pyramidal like structure, thus increasing our with the accuracy and the results. The training of data took around 7 to 8 hours, running on the GPU power with 16 GB RAM. So I could not upload the whole video for that. Now, since our model is trained, now we save our model as model 25, since 25 epoch layers have been set up. Now we test for the accuracy, and the accuracy we got is 96% accuracy for the training of the data sets. Running the score, we get around 96% accuracy for the data sets. Now going on the results, random results that we generated through it, and we found that the accuracy was quite good enough for running after running our results. We test the random images ourselves of the developers that we run our project, and the accuracy was quite good enough. Running our data sets on the real-time data sets is also very nice. Coming to the publication part, I am glad to say that our two papers, that's one, the survey paper, has been published in ICCR 2020 International Conference on Intelligent Communication and Computational Research, at Punjab Institute of Technology, Rajpura, and final implementation paper published in IJICA, that's the International Journal of Innovative Computing and Application. This is my SNAP for the certificate for paper presentation at Rajpura and SNAP for the survey paper. These are some of the references that came as a helping hand throughout the year for our project. Lastly, I would like to thank my project guide, Ms. Aishwarya Gupta, and my project members for their contribution in this project. Thank you.